Tuesday episode on the free tea. So Hershey was last week, right?
Yes, it was my first time there, and I have to say it was extremely overwhelming. So if anyone's been to Hershey Park, they have all the parking lots literally just filled with anything and everything you can imagine that's old.
Yeah, it's pretty great. You can pretty much find, as far as if you're into like a pre-64 car, you can probably find almost anything you can think of for the car at the swap meet. We usually spend basically Tuesday through Friday there. Mike, you came up Wednesday?
Yeah, I spent all day Wednesday there. We walked like 10 miles and only covered two lots.
Yeah. So we were on a mission. I mean, we were on a mission looking for parts in general, but you know, Mike was there and we were kind of scouting for stuff for this car. And obviously we're trying to get it as cheap as possible, if not buy a few things that we can flip to pay for stuff. So we got a pair of Wi-Fi wheels.
Yes, two of them.
And what did we pay for those?
$20.
$20. So we paid $20 for those, but shortly after buying those, I bought an old Volkswagen roof rack for $60.
$60 or $80.
And I sold that for $350. So
that was sold before we even left,
yes,
correct?
Pretty much, yeah. So that paid for the wheels and then some. So that definitely covered the cost of those wheels by far. The other thing that I got then on Thursday is I bought front rear cross members, Model A cross members, which are kind of universal and nice to use. And I paid $60 for the pair of those. So again, the profit from the roof rack basically paid for these as well. I also bought a reverse eye rear Model A spring for the Sweet Heart Roadster. That project is nowhere near free. That's the farthest thing from free. And so that, I had the original spring that came on the Sweet Heart Roadster that donated its main leaf and spring pieces to this car. So we got a rear spring for free through a roundabout way of doing that. The last thing that we got, or actually two more things. So I went to the local scrapyard, which is it's like an organized scrapyard that's really cool, called Gwix.
Also overwhelming because it's just stuff everywhere.
I love these places.
It's the best.
So I went there. It's pretty much organized. They buy out industrial places and they tear them down and they salvage all the metal and then they organize it. So you can, this frame table, I got all the I-beams from there. They have an I-beam aisle and you can pick your I-beams. So they have a box tubing aisle. So I went and got one by one eighth wall tubing that we're going to use for the inner structure of the body to kind of frame it all out and make it less wood and more metal. I paid $15 for, five 8 foot sticks. So $50 total for 5 sticks of that. And then I also, after not having enough for Hershey, went to an auction that was sort of mislisted.
And it didn't help, it was the Saturday after Hershey as well.
Yeah. So they just had an ad that said flathead parts in with a bunch of like industrial tools. And I was like, why not show up? Well, here the guy was an old racer, the person that had passed away, and there was all kinds of just boxes of just flathead stuff. And mixed in with that was some really good stuff. I got some, I basically took home a whole entire truckload of flathead parts, some speed equipment, some all kinds of stuff, mostly stock, but a bunch of speed equipment for like $200. What I got out of there is I got three more Wi-Fi wheels for $5, which is really great. So now we have a set of five Wi-Fis for this car for $5. And we're going to sell a bunch of that stuff that will most definitely pay for this and then some profit, which will be nice that it'll cover some of the other stuff. So that's where we're at. We got four wheels, we got a spring, we got cross members, we got box tubing. We got enough shit to start making a car.
We're gonna have all kinds of rollers.
It's gonna be fun. So we'll have lots of rolling rusty projects around here.
Nothing finished, just rolling.
Yeah. Well, whatever. So we're gonna take this body back apart, and I got a ton of measurements, and we're gonna try and get a frame kind of pieced together here, at least a perimeter frame, and then we can start working on some other stuff. But we wanna try and get this frame sort of tack welded together so we can start building up from there. So yeah, let's get started. 7 or so at night and decided to call it quits because of the noise, and number one, I didn't want to piss the neighbors off too much. So we called it a night. A lot more pizza eating and shooting the crap happened than work, but we definitely made some progress. A lot of it just needed to be hashed out. We just had to talk, figure out a plan. A
lot of measuring and remeasuring, because these rails kind of aren't normally what you use, and it's kind of trying to figure things out for basically from scratch.
Yeah, but these rails, what we're finding, are actually pretty perfect as far as like the step that it has naturally in the rear, and it has a little bit of a sweep in the front. So like as far as getting the car nice and low, I think it's going to be pretty sweet. Just a quick kind of short couple things that we did. So we found the center. We found basically we wanted to channel the body right at the beads in the back of the seat. So we set the frame rails up accordingly. We cut the back of the rails out and just left this top strip here. What we're going to do is get that welded in place, and then we're going to make some nice pieces that are going to wrap around the cross member and fit around, and then we're going to lop off the ends of these cross member. We wanted to leave it long just in case we have to do any adjustment. We don't screw ourselves by cutting it now and then realize we need to move it out a little bit in the final assembly of the frame. So we got this all set up in here. We had to raise the cross member about 4 inches from my fixture that I have for some other A-frames that I've built. And now everything kind of clamped in place. And the next step is going to be setting the front cross member width. What we found is the cowl is so freaking narrow on that thing. What was it?
2 foot roughly. That's in between, there's a little lips where the firewall would have riveted to. It's about 2 foot, and that's like a couple inches up from the bottom, because ours doesn't exist at the bottom. So it's about 2 foot, so we want that to sit over the edge of the frame rails. So partway up, we need it to be about 2 foot, so we have to do a little working of the frame rails to get it to fit, hopefully.
Yeah, I think we have a game plan. So once we get the front cross member sitting in at the width of a 32 grow, I have an old chopped 32 grow we're going to use, and we measured the width of that. We're going to kind of set the front cross member opening, or the in between the rails, at that width. And what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to do some pie cuts and basically pull the center area at the cowl, pinch it in so that it will fit into the rails, so we can channel it down over it. So that's going to take a little bit of work, but
it's definitely not as easy as setting up the Sweet Heart Roadster frame. There's a lot more massaging that we need to do with it. But it'll look cool when it's done, definitely.
And it's going to be free.
That's the key.
Basically free.
Yes.
So that's all we got for this time. Next week we're going to work on getting cross member set up and getting it a little further. But definitely a fun little project, just working with what we have and not going out and buying new stuff. It's kind of cool. It's challenging our problem solving, because you got to think, what can we do? I mean, we could have bought some different stuff, but using exactly what we have, it's kind of challenging us a little more, and we're going to make it work. It's going to be awesome. So thanks guys for watching. Catch you later.